the precautionary measures. Apart from that, also studying and completing your work in time. So before starting with today's class, let me tell you the thought for the day. And the thought for the day says, you will never have this day again. So make it count. Now, what does this thought mean? It means that time will never come back. What you have got today, you will not get it tomorrow again. So you should respect time and do all possible and positive things that you could do on that particular day or that particular moment or time so that in future you don't regret it. So always be active, be alert, be punctual and make use of the day, make use of the moment that you have got. Make it a memorable one, not only for you, but for everybody around you. So today we are going to start the poem Rain on the Roof by Coates Keenan from your Beehive book. Speaking about the poet, Coates Keenan was a poet, he was a journalist and also a politician from US. And this poem he had written when he was studying. So one day when he was sitting in his hostel room and it was raining. So from his room he was watching the rainfall and he got these ideas which he had written in the form of a poem. So let's see what the poem speaks about. The entire poem is on the literary device called personification, right? The poet is using the literary device, the poetic device, personification throughout his poem. So let's start with the poem. Let's read it. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weaves in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of the cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain over it. So what does the poet here say? The poet says that when the atmosphere is full of moisture, right? It is full of moisture over the starry sphere. Starry sphere here stands for the sky which is full of stars, and then the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. So what has happened? The humidity had covered the entire sky, the starry sphere. Now the stars are not seen, right? And the poet says, since all the stars are hidden behind the clouds, it appears as if the darkness is very sad. Why? Because the stars are not twinkling. Because it is all the darkness is all sad, it is full of sorrow. So and it weeps. As it is weeping, what is happening? The tears are falling down, and these tears which are falling down, he says, is the rain. What a bliss to press the pillow of the cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain over it. And then the poet says, it is such a happiness. It's great happiness to lie down on your bed during such rainy day or night. Right? When you press your pillow and you lie down on the bed and listen to the patter sounds made by the rain, raindrops that are falling. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being stuck. And he says that every tinkle, tinkle here stands for the ringing sound that is made by the droplets, drops of rain that is falling on the shingle. What is a shingle? Shingle is the roof, right? It is a roof made out of wood. So when the water droplets, when the rain drops fall on it, tinkling sound he sees, and this sound keeps on echoing in your heart. Right? You can hear it again and again, and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being stuck. And when you're listening to these raindrops fall on the roof, you start imagining things. Right? Thousands of things you start imagining, your imagination gets on to work and weave the air threads into woof as I listen to the patter of the rain on the roof. And then the poet says that what happens, these imaginations, they try to weave themselves into the pattern of making a cloth. Have you seen ever the handloom machines? How the thread goes zigzag, zigzag, isn't it? One comes from here, the other overlaps it, then again one comes over it. So that way, the way how the cloth is weaved on the hand weaving machine. So same way the poet says that the imaginations, the thoughts are weaving themselves as if they are weaving themselves into a piece of cloth. And when does this happen? This happens when the rain falls on the shingles, making the patter sound. So here we see the line is repeated as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. So here it can be an example of poetic device, refrain, right? Where the lines are repeated for poetic effect. You might have heard the songs also. In the songs also, not many times the line is repeated. So what figure of speech is that? That is refrain. Now, in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers, ere she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. So now, the poet says that when he sees this rainy season, when he sees the rain falling down, he loves to hold his pillow and lie down on his bed. First thing. Second thing, during the season, what happens? He has got lot of thoughts, thousands of thoughts that come to his mind. Along with the thoughts, he also is reminded of the olden things, the past memory. And the major memory is of his mother. He remembers his mother, who is now dead, right? She is no more, and he remembers each and everything about his mother. To regard the darling dreamers, is an old English word which means before, right? So how do you read it? You read it to regard the darling dreamers before she left them till the dawn. And what would the mother do? Mother loved, mother enjoyed gazing at her children, looking at her children when they are sleeping and dreaming. She would not disturb them. She would not wake them up, but would sit and look at them and be happy when she would see that her children are so relaxed and they are sleeping and they are dreaming. So she felt this very, she liked this very much. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain. And the poet, as he is able to remember the way the mother used to look at him, he even remembers it still today. So he says that even today when it rains, or when I am asleep, I feel that my mother is looking at me. Fond, loving. She is still looking at me with so much of love and affection. I can feel her eyes on me. As I list to this refrain, list here stands for listen. So as I listen to this refrain, refrain as I have already told you, the repetition of the lines. So he says as I listen to these repetition of the lines. Now here what does this line mean? It means when the raindrops are falling on the roof, on the shingle, they are continuously making the same sound. The sound does not change until and unless the intensity of the rain decreases. the rain when it is falling on the roof, which is played upon the shingles by the pattern of the rain. So, just as I have told you already, that this refrain is made by the sound of the rain that is falling on the shingles, that is on the roof, and he is enjoying it, he is listening to it, and he is a carefree person when he is remembering his mother and weaving his other thoughts. So this is how the poem ends, which tells us more about the thoughts of the poet, right? The thoughts of the poet and what are his feelings towards the rain. I hope you all have understood the poem. So, until we meet in our next video, keep learning, keep experiencing, stay safe, take care.